May I come in, sir?
Yes.
Yeah, please, please come in.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah. Switch it on. Switch it on. Is it on? Yeah, please, be seated. Okay, Mr. Samit Saurabh Naik. Say something about yourself that will prove that you are suitable for this post that you have applied for.
Well, sir, the first thing that makes me suitable for this job is I am an agriculture graduate. So the first requirement is this graduation, and second is I am disciplined, and I am ready to work at harsh conditions and directly interact with farmers. I am ready for it.
Okay. So why did you decide to join this banking industry, banking sector? What sort of relationship, personal or family relationship, that with farmers or farming that you decided to be a part of this banking industry?
So the first thing is it.
Why did you pursue educational career in agriculture?
Sir, actually I had this interest in agriculture because everyone...
You have got very much interest. You are very much interested towards farming, agriculture.
Not exactly interested, but I got influenced by my friends. Everyone was saying that yes, this is a very good sector and you must pursue your career in this.
So you don't have any personal choice, you don't have any personal interest towards that. I mean, you said that not exactly interest, but you got influenced by your seniors, that it's a very good sector. Sector for what? What is good about this sector, academically? Banking sector. Banking is a sector, agriculture is the profession that we are going to do.
Banking, sir, the job opportunity is good and the growth in this sector is good, so it will definitely help me to...
You don't have any personal interest towards this sector, you are influenced by your friends.
Not exactly in banking, sir, I am interested in banking, and here the growth of your personal career is good, so...
And what's about agriculture? Are you getting my point? I asked you that, why did you pursue your educational career in the field of agriculture? Why not in the field of engineering, medical, or any other things? Why agriculture?
Sir, I was interested in all my family members are also involved in farming. So I had this curiosity to towards this.
Who is interested in farming in your family?
Sir, my uncle, my paternal uncle, and my brother. He's.
What do they farm?
Sir.
What do they farm? What do they farm?
They cultivate. What?
Sir, they are much into commercial products like cashew. And flowers.
Mm-hmm. You basically belong to which area? Koraput?
Yes, sir. I'm basically from Cuttack district, but I'm born and brought up in Koraput.
Koraput. Okay. Now tell me something about Koraput, the farming utility, the banking utility of Koraput.
Sir,
why I'm asking this question? Because you have applied for AFO, a banking aspirant. So I just want to taste that. As a banking aspirant, how much you are aware of these banking things and all?
Sir, as far as the farming part is concerned...
What is the prime source of income of Koraput?
Sir, prime source of income is, sir, farming is, mainly it is farming only.
What type of farming?
They cultivate cereals and in somewhere they are going for vegetables.
Vegetables. What are the challenges? What are the challenges? How many years you live in Koraput?
Sir, 17 years.
17 years. You did your graduation over there?
No, sir. Graduation in
Bhavani. Intermediate.
Again, sir?
Intermediate. You did your intermediate?
Yes, sir.
In Koraput?
Yes, sir.
Now, tell me that what are the challenges these days the farmers are facing?
Sir, starting from the beginning, they are not getting the seed properly, they are not getting the seed material, planting material, and after cultivation, they are unable to market their produce, and during the process of farming, they are facing many environmental hazards.
How do you think that you are going to resolve this problem, the challenges? You can provide the farmers with solutions.
Sir, first of all, get them insured, get that crop insured. If something happens, then they will have that money to support the family. And second thing is, make them aware about the different schemes of governments, which they can use to modernize their farming. And after that, teach them how to go for commercial farming, have a commercial approach for the farming. Because most of the farmers in Koraput area, they go for substantial farming, and they just cultivate it, they consume it.
What is the best help that you can provide to the farmers living there?
Sir, financial assistance is the best thing
Bank can provide the financial assistance. As an AFO, what do you do? Because you are not going to finance them personally. You are going to sanction the loans. Loans are provided by the banks. I asked you that what is the best help that you can provide to the farmers?
We can tell them about the different schemes of governments which they can avail, and most of the farmers are actually unaware about the schemes.
You are going to make them aware about the loans and schemes,
Yes, sir.
the financial assistance that the bank is providing.
Yes, sir.
Anything else that apart from this, like everybody can do that. What you for your farm?
Sir, because I'm an agriculture graduate, I can help them from that aspect also, give them tips regarding farming from agriculture point of view.
Okay. What are your extracurricular activities?
Sir, I love to read. Means recently I have developed this habit of reading.
Reading. You have mentioned that you have read a book like The Diary of a Young Girl
Yes, sir.
in The Alchemist.
Yes, sir.
Can you please tell me the author? Name of the author of this book?
Actually, the author of The Alchemist is Paulo Coelho, and The Diary of the Young Girl is an autobiography. It's actually the diary of a girl named Anne Frank, and the story revolves around her life during the World War II Holocaust.
What did you learn from that? From autobiography?
From autobiography, it's actually the thinking, the perception of a girl, how earlier she used to be very arrogant, but with due
How
process.
many autobiographies that you have read?
So actually, this is the only one I have read.
Why didn't you prefer to read the autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam, the autobiography of Mahatma Gandhi and others? And why do you choose to read the autobiography of a person who belongs to foreign countries?
Sir, I actually at that time I was very much interested in World War II, so I got this book that it describes the life of.
And what are you reading right now?
Right now I'm reading recently I'm not reading anything.
What really demotivates you and what motivates you? What demotivates you and what motivates
Motivation, I get it from the growth and development I see in myself. It's a small little things that motivates me. Like actually I was overweight. I was weighing around 76, 77 kgs. I started working out, and that little decrease in my weight that motivated me. Small things, they motivate me. And in terms of demotivation, I see.
If something motivates you, then there must be something which motivates you. Or you can say that nothing can be motivated. What is your weak point?
Big point is I try to overdo things.
Overdo things.
Yes.
How are you managing
Just letting it be how it is supposed to be. Means not overdoing things, because I always try to achieve the
problem.
Yes, sir.
Apart from the agricultural finance, if you supposed to do some non-agricultural works, right? Sir, then what are the non-agricultural loans are there, advances are there in the banking sector?
Sorry, sir, I'm not exactly aware about.
Okay, it is retail loans and MSME loans, right? Do you know what is retail loans and MSME loans?
Sir, I know about MSME loans. They are the loans related to micro and small medium farmers.
Then, do you know who is our agriculture cabinet minister, union cabinet minister, and he is from which constituency?
I know the name, sir. I don't know the constituency. He is Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar.
Okay, tell me, who is our MSME minister?
Sorry, sir,
Union MSME minister, and he is also minister of road transport minister also.
Right. Is Nitin Gadkari.
He is from which constituency?
Constituency, sir, actually I don't know.
He is from Nagpur, Maharashtra.
He is from Maharashtra, that I know, but
right. Constituency. Nagpur, Maharashtra constituency, right. Okay. What is the priority sector advances? Tell me, what is the priority sector advances?
Priority sector, sir.
Priority sector means a sector in which you are focusing much more rather than the other loans. Means agriculture is the most priority sector advances, right? How much percentage you have to give to the priority sector advances?
No idea.
It is 40%, right? 40% loan should be given to the priority sector advances. Okay. Then you tell me, what are the government deposit schemes are there from the Ministry of Finance? Government deposit schemes.
Deposit schemes.
Means what is PPF, then what is sovereign gold bond, like this other government deposit schemes, what is KBP, tell me some two three schemes are there, and elaborate all those things in just one two lines.
For PPF and EPF, there EPF means employees provident fund, and PPF is there, and apart from them NPS is their national pension scheme, where employee, he contributes during his service and after that he gets the pension.
Okay, then tell me, what is sovereign gold bond?
Sir, I have no idea about it.
Then you tell me the Sukanya Samruddhi scheme. Tell me why, what is that, and why it is required and necessary for that?
So Sukanya Samruddhi scheme is for actually girl child aging from 1 to 10 years, and the maximum deposit of that scheme is 1,50,000
per month or per year?
Per year.
Per year. Okay. Then what is the maximum debt time limit, then it will be closed, account will be closed, Sukanya, Sukanya account.
It is 10 years of age.
No, 10 years is the minimum age, the maximum age that can open an account, right? I am asking, what is the age limit, then you can close the account?
Sir,
it is 21 years, upon the age of 21 years, account should be closed. Then do you know, some partial withdrawal facility is there in case of Sukanya Samruddhi account. Why, what is that partial withdrawal in case of any emergency? Means any marriage purpose, health ground, some provisions are there. Okay. One more thing, you just tell me, what is the scheme for the senior citizen? Senior Citizen Savings Scheme, SCSS. Okay, some schemes are there for senior citizen. Okay, first tell me, what is senior citizen?
Citizens so whose age is more than 60 years.
Okay. And one more thing, in the MSME small category, what is the turnover required to get the loan in the MSME sector in the small category?
Sir, I'm unable to recall it.
Okay, there are three categories are there: micro, small, and medium. Okay, Then last question, you tell me, what are the three schemes are there in the Mudra loan?
Sir, one is Sisu, where up to 50,000 cash will be given. And another one is Kishore, where from ranging from 50,000 to 5 lakh amount will be disbursed. And the third one is Tarun, that is more than 5 lakh will be given.
Okay, what is its margin? Do you know?
No sir, I don't know the margin.
Okay, thank you.
Sambit Saurabh Naik, you are doing what you are doing, BSc is you have completed in the year 2000. MSc, which subject you are pursuing?
Floriculture and landscaping.
Floriculture and landscaping.
Yes, sir.
Very good. You just now we are discussing, actually you told that Mudra loans, three categories of loans are there, no? Shishu, Kishore, Tarun. Tarun, which is lowest is Kishishu, then after that?
Kishore,
then Tarun. Okay, that is their margin and other things you have told. What are the types of loan covered under this Mudra loan scheme? What type of loans can be given under this Mudra scheme?
So loan can be given to non-corporate and non-farming MSME sectors.
Non-farming sectors. Okay, very good. That means only non-farming sectors cannot be given.
No.
But whether this dairy farming, dairy loans, goatery loans, fishery loans, whether this type, this is a farming activity or non-farming activity?
Actually, it will be allied activity of...
Allied activities, okay. Whether this type of allied activities can be covered under this Mudra scheme?
No sir, I don't know about the details.
You told na non-farming activity, correct, that is the answer. But recent addition is there recently, means the last one and a half years back, even this dairy allied activity, the dairy farming, they are also covered under this Mudra loan scheme. That is pure farming activities, agriculture means crop cultivation aspect, that cannot be considered under Mudra scheme. Okay, theek hai, it is just some correction. You told that actually some cultivation, your parents, they are engaged in some cultivation work, na? Cashew nut, something you are told, na? Cashew nut, what are other crops they are cultivating?
They go for flower cultivation.
Flower, what type of flowers?
Sir, gladiolus and gerbera.
Gerbera, gladiolus, they are doing it.
And tuberose also.
So they are doing actually commercial purpose, they are cultivating.
Yes.
It is being marketed?
Local market? No, they are cultivating in Cuttack.
Cuttack?
Yes.
Which area?
Cuttack, Athagad.
Eh?
Athagad.
Achha, Jorbera also it is cultivated?
Yes.
Achha. Okay, what is the scientific name of Jorbera? Cashew nut, you tell, what is the scientific name of cashew nut?
Anacardium occidental.
Anacardium occidental. What is the family?
Anacardiasis, sir, I think.
You are a student of horticulture. It is Anacardiasis only. Okay. From the same family, can you name some other crop? Prominent crops. Okay, fruit crops, you tell. You are a student of horticulture. Fruit crops.
Fruit crops are... apple is there, pineapple.
Pineapple is from Anacardiasis family?
No, sir. Food crops, I'm telling. And
I am talking actually. You told that actually it is Anacardium occidentale, that is correct. Family is Anacardiaceae. Why I am asking actually from Anacardiaceae family, any name of the crop you know?
No, sir.
What about mango? Which family it being belongs? Very prominent crop. Mango. Mangifera indica, it belongs to Anacardiaceae only, is not it? Which family? Now you recollect? Okay. What is the scope of then actually when you are involved in this, your family is involved in this cultivation of flowers, and that two exotic flowers, gladiolus you are telling, gerbera, what are other exotic flowers they are cultivating? That means?
Sir, I have seen these three crops only.
Three crops, cashew nut, gladiolus and gerbera.
Yes, sir. Gladiolus in Jagra in field and cashew.
Where it is being marketed actually? In Kottak or Bhubaneswar?
Flowers there mainly, sir. The flowers that they are producing, they are being marketed in Bhubaneswar only. And
how to preserve a cot flowers for a long time?
So the simple way is, sir, polythene wrapping. If you wrap the flower with polythene, then the shelf life gets increased for 3-4 days.
That is a natural way. Any other way to preserve the cot flowers for a long time? Because you are involved in cot flower, gerbera, gladiolus, these are cot flowers. Any ways to preserve for it long time? Because it is required. Otherwise,
no, sir. Actually,
No. Some chemical is added in the water.
Sir, I am unable to recall that chemical name.
Is it copper sulfate? Okay. What is the intensive agriculture? What is the extensive agriculture? Okay. Okay. Yes, because you are, see, you need not be prepared, because horticulture means equal this
horticulture,
specialization in horticulture.
Specialization.
Masters in horticulture. You should know intensive horticulture crops, actually they are more for intensive cultivation. Okay.
Definitely, things are going to be, one of the questions will be there from this.
Yes, this is possible. Your subject there from your subject. And cashew nut, you yourself you have told that cashew nut, gladiolus, gerbera, you have told.
You prepare yourself properly.
Immediately some question will be there, no? What is the name of the family?
Your second
and is mango. Mango, if you Anacardiaceae family, is a very prominent name. That is why I am telling prominent name. Okay. What is actually some very mango, alternate bearing in mango? You know, no any idea?
Yes, sir.
What is that alternate bearing in mango?
Actually, the mango tree, it flowers in alternate years. This year it is not, next year it won't. The next year after that,
it will flower. It's not like that actually. It is like that. There is some heavy flowering, like a heavy crop will be 1 year, and there will be next year that will be lean crop. What is the reason behind that? Any reason?
It's physiological disorder.
Physiological disorder? Or physiological characteristics. Why it is a disorder? It is not a disorder.
What is your extracurricular activity?
Playing chess.
This is a hobby. What is your extracurricular activity? Okay. No extracurricular activity you have. Only you have hobbies. You are not interested in any other thing. Okay. Do you know the man who represents India in chess these days?
Sir,
any other than Vishwanath Anand? How many times is he world champion? You need to have proper preparation of those things. Okay. So feedback is that, look, the same feedback I suppose.
Yes, actually subject knowledge actually you should actually develop.
Ross, sir, strong preparation on banking.
Banking and
subject knowledge.
Actually concentration will be on subject knowledge.
Subject knowledge.
Because banking also is yet to join the bank.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, some preliminary actually okay, whatever you are asking. But subject knowledge actually no, you are expected to know these things. Horticulture, you are having horticulture. Questions was asked on horticulture. Whatever question I put, that is only purely horticulture question. So horticulture question actually, of course you have some answer, you could give some answer, but at least these are the very simple questions I put.
He is not confident to answer this question.
Yes.
You have to expertise in your field.
This horticulture, there are very actually basic rudimentary questions I put, is of horticulture.
So next time, I wish that you should definitely prepare for this, there are hours that are with you.
Little cross up.
Communication, you need to speak up, your voice is not audible, you are just, you know, vanishing your voice, speak it up and, you know, you are good, body language is good and all, but nervousness is there. As you know that you are not comfortable answering the questions, you don't have that much of knowledge because of the lack of preparation. You are good, but you are lacking in preparation. So that backup is not there with you right now. So that is really diminishing your confidence level and that is reflected on your face. Otherwise, body language, everything is fantastic, but you need to speak up. Voice is not audible to us. And we are not going to tell you again and again that please speak up and tell us. No.
Is that clear? Okay. So work in your pitch of voice, otherwise everything is good. Just browse up your knowledge. Especially in the field of agriculture, horticulture,
yes,
and banking,
yes,
and current affairs, okay? Because this is not excusable. You have spent a lot of time over there. Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Let's do this.